So I would like to invite Olga Nevska. Olga Nevska is the CEO, the Managing Director of Telekom's Mobility Solutions. Deutsche Telekom has one of the largest fleet in Germany. And Olga will take us through the why, the what, and the how of the shortly to be launched connected mobility services at Germany's second largest fleet. And maybe some of you know Olga already. Olga was also one of the winners of the Smart Mobility Award from last year in November from Fleet Europe. And Olga is also well known in Germany. She's actually selected, or she's in the top 100 women, leading women who are promoting Germany on a commercial side. So we are very happy to have you here. Very grateful for that, Olga. Thank you very much. And I would say the floor is yours.
Thanks a lot, and greetings from Bonn, headquarters of Deutsche Telekom. I'm very happy to be here, and it's an honor to open the first session of Smart Mobility Institute in this year. I'm Olga Nevska, thanks for introduction. I'm CEO of Telekom Mobility Solutions. I'm originally actually from Ukraine, and 20 years ago I came to Germany and stayed here. I studied economics and law, I did my PhD in Germany. I joined Telekom 2009, so I actually spent a lot of time with connectivity on the other side, from the telco side. 2019, I took over Mobility Solutions, internal mobility provider of Deutsche Telekom, with a clear exercise and objective from the board. Olga, we need sustainable mobility for all employees, and you please bring USB from Telekom, from connectivity on the mobility side, and do something interesting from this. So this what I started with 2019 with. And I'd love to give you an overview actually what is Mobility Solutions is. Would you please go on the next page? Perfect. In a lot of big companies and DAX companies, corporate mobility is still splitted in different departments. I had great experience with Orange, its telco company in France. They brought corporate mobility in one department. We're still not there, but we communicate and work very closely together. So V-Mobility Solutions is actually coming from the fleet, and we're going very actively in the direction of mobility provider. But yes, we're coming from the fleet, and we're responsible to move telecom. So we have 24,000 vehicles in Germany and 14,000 in European countries, because each of you, once you need to get internet at home, there's one technician guys coming with the vehicle and also responsible for digitalization. So 24,000 vehicles in Germany, another 14 in European countries. We are also responsible, we see ourselves not only as the fleet, we're responsible for connectivity and innovation in the company. So we also have car sharing, own car sharing only for employees of Deutsche Telekom in Germany with 60 stations Germany-wide. We have long history of telecom shuttle, bringing people from different offices in Bonn, between Bonn, Frankfurt, Bonn, Darmstadt, so the biggest travel roads in Germany. And since 2020, we switch to the shuttle on demand. So it's also an interesting example of connectivity, having own app and very good data-driven services. Of course, we have bicycles in Germany, 10,000, and another 2,000 in European countries, and in this summer we're launching the first mobility as a service corporate solution in Germany, and this is what I'm going to speak with you about. But what I'd love to speak with you with and give your opinion, I would love to go on the next page, how we understand sustainable mobility and what we think about corporate mobility contributing to this. So first of all, you probably know the trends which impacting mobility development, and mobility actually is under biggest disruption comparing to all other industries. So it's sharing as a trend, platform-driven economy, autonomous driving coming one day, electrification, we already see this trend, and connectivity actually giving the biggest chance for seamless, sustainable, guaranteed, hopefully shared mobility for all. Speaking about sustainable mobility, some people say, and when I started working with mobility solution, some people told me, bring more electric vehicles and you will reach sustainable mobility. So how we understand sustainable mobility, and actually definition was developed by World Bank. So first of all, it's security. So I think mobility has to be secure and safe. But within digitalization and data, it becomes new definition. Also, data usage need to be secure and used by trusted data provider. Efficient, and I do understand not only cost efficiency, but it's about providing right mobility for the right money, for the right point of time. So I think it's very important to understand like this. Green mobility, it's reducing CO2. So it's switching, if we can, to e-vehicles or zero mobility or shared mobility. So we will speak of it, but it's reduction of CO2. And what is, I think, crucial is unified access for mobility and namely seamless guaranteed mobility. So connectivity is actually must to enable unified access. And digitalization is a key. We have a lot of discussion with employee of Deutsche Telekom in Germany. So we have huge portfolio starting with public transport ticketing and e-vehicles. And the most common response why people still stick with own vehicle, own car is, it's too complicated. I have to use different apps. I have to use different billing modes. It's too complicated. It's not comfortable. So unified access for mobility will become crucial importance in the next decade. Taking all these trends and our understanding for sustainable mobility, we look also, VSDT, of course, we're also causing some CO2 due to mobility. So how this split look like? And frankly speaking, we were surprised that fleet worldwide, so I didn't mention we also have US fleet, 20% of the total CO2 caused by mobility, another 8% travel. So at the digital company, we're actually using WebEx and Microsoft Teams since years. So we already very successful in reducing CO2 and travel management. And the biggest part, 70%, coming from commuting, which normally wasn't in the focus of fleet or travel management. So all employees of DT who's commuting besides of Corona, of course, we reduced this one, commuting to the work also causing CO2, and they haven't covered by this time this segment. So the question was, what is holistic approach to push sustainable mobility, corporate mobility for Deutsche Telekom? And we come up with the following approach. Please go to the next page. First of all, we want to give sustainable and guaranteed mobility for all employees. Normally at the fleet, I serve only corporate vehicles or service vehicles. Travel management will serve people who's traveling. But we want to cover all 100,000, first we're focusing on Germany, all 100,000 employees in Germany, giving all sustainable mobility, and it's crucial. Of course, it's important to secure mobility. Our employees need to be satisfied with this, so it's not a solution probably to give all electric vehicles or to take vehicles away. So customer satisfaction, employee satisfaction, it's crucial for us. We need to think about efficiency, also cost efficiency, it's topic, and sustainability becoming crucial in our mindset. So we said, from my perspective, the fleet, we have to make fleet green and efficient. Efficient not only from cost, which means right mobility for the right time, but taking sustainability in corporate seriously It's not a solution to give everybody electric vehicles. We need to cover all employees, and it's possible only due to mobility as a service. So moving from ownership to usership and provide mobility as a service to all employees with different modes, with seamless mobility and connectivity. We decided for the strategy 2019, so now in total 3 years after, I would give you our approach and where we're standing for with this approach. So first we said, and we can go on the next page, it might help us, how we proceed, how we implement this approach. First, we need to improve our portfolio and not only buying vehicles, but also with strong partners. I will explain what kind of partners, what we're doing on this. Secondly, we need to send on innovative digital services. And third, we need to go to the new ecosystem, mobility as a service, which based on connectivity. So what we're doing in portfolio. So first of all, we have, I would say, pretty big portfolio, mobility portfolio for employees. So we have subscription for public transport, subscription for railways. We have company car, we have service fleet, we have bicycle, we have possibility to give bicycle to our employees. What is important for us, of course, diversified also power portfolio. So we implement electric vehicles if it's possible. If it's not, we set on utilization. So sharing, and the precondition for this is actually connectivity. I will come to this now. Flexibility, it's another topic which is very important, especially in the company car. So normally we used to give one car in the company field for 3 years. Now we're moving from this point. We say it should be purpose-driven vehicles. So our employees who has right to get company car should get flexibility to decide what kind of car they need or they don't need at all. And it's also connected service because we have app for this purpose and we provide digital service to our employees. And I should say we have great pilot with 6 companies and I'm very satisfied with the results. So first, we need this diversified portfolio with different transport providers. And it's not only about leasing, it's not only about buying everything, it's about set of partners with different transport modes. It's crucial. Third, digital services. We cannot speak about connectivity if our products doesn't have API and not don't have digital access. It's very important for us. So we have mobility app. It's app which we're establishing in the company to provide all employees first access to different transport providers and portfolio parts. First. Second, we also support it with digital services, starting from driving license, book for electronische Fahrtenbuch, I forget translation. It's a book to track kilometers, is it private or it's business purpose. And crucial, it's pooling and sharing, because especially for vehicles, which we cannot shift to electric vehicles, we want to increase utilization and own car sharing fleet. It might be also leased or bought, whatever. It's crucial as the connectivity to increase utilization. And those topics are already in place. To provide connected mobility to all employees, we decided to establish our own platform. I think Germany has some specific care. For example, we have different taxation for different transport providers. So I know some great example from Swiss, for example, on mobility budget. This is something what we decided not to set up in Deutsche Telekom because of taxation difficulties and regulations. So we decided to provide all employees with the digital access to connected mobility. What does it mean? And I would ask to go to the next page. Starting from summer, we will provide app which give the possibility our employee to go from A to B on intermodal mode. If you have the chance to go on this link, mock-up link, we can show how the app working. Important to say, it's not something, yes, make it bigger, you go, if you click on the mobility as a service, the Magenta app, perfect, and you just click, enter destination. So that give possibility our employee to say, I want to go from A to B, I give my location, you go down, yes. We can decide either it's CO2 better way, or it's time efficient way, or it's maybe more cost efficient way. You say where's your location, where you're going, you click in search the trip. Yeah, you can choose either it's, I think it's the greenest way now, and you can get intermodal proposal how to go from A to B. If you click further, there is one bill, so we go for the one-stop shop. First, it looks easy to have such an app. It's mock-up, we have already this app live. The difficulty is to provide seamless journey. Of course, connectivity is the key for this, but you need to make sure that you integrate it on the platform, all different transport provider deep. So you make it possible for employees of a customer to book one time, to pay one time, and also get the information if, for example, train will be late in to change the journey. So what we made possible for summer, we will start first with the pilot in Bonn Cologne area. So it's about 20,000 employees of Deutsche Telekom. Our headquarters also based in Bonn, and why we first decided to start on the in this region, for us it's important to integrate public transport. I think public transport in the intermodal connected trip will be crucial, but also covering, of course, with the public transport provider, the car sharing, scooter and bicycle, last mile. So we got confirmation from the public transport in the region Cologne-Bonn to get deep integration on our platform. We have also, other public transport provider in this region. So starting from June, we will pilot it in Bonn, Cologne, as I told, for 18,000 employees of DT. We're planning this pilot for 6 months to see what we can do better, what we can fix, what we can improve. We might think about also subsidizing public transport and or maybe giving some money on top of the budget to push switch from own vehicle to sustainable mobility. But what we decided to do first is provide access. Of course, DT also thinking about some other commercial models coming from this solution. Because if we look in the future, connectivity will be probably the best business case, which provides also possibility to create new business models. And we can think, I think Netherlands a great example, so people buying apartments with the mobility on subscription. This is what we also think about, but the first pilot and the first priority is to provide our employees with the access to seamless, connected, guaranteed mobility. I'm very excited how this pilot will come up with our employees, and we'll be happy to share in autumn our experience on this. We're waiting for this. We have great feedback for the first customers who's testing our MVP. Very excited and waiting for this. It will be interesting to see other information today to understand what other companies also doing on connected sustainable mobility in corporates. Thanks a lot.
So Olga, thank you so much. That was really interesting. 22,000 colleagues in Bonn Cologne area. Am I correct?
Yes. I said 18, but actually it's like 22.
Yeah, wow, amazing. That's really...
It's If we look that in Germany, we have 100,000 employees, so the biggest part concentrated in Bonn, Cologne area.
Yeah.
This is why we decided to start with this region.
Yeah, perfect. Wow, really impressive. So thank you so much. Yeah, if anybody has a question for Olga, please put them in the chat and I will read them out. I have some questions in the meantime. What triggers me is that you say you open this up for all employees. So also the commuters that have maybe only 5 kilometers to travel to work or 10 kilometers to travel. How do you designate the amount of mobility budget? And normally you have, if you live 10 kilometers away in the Netherlands, you get, 50 cents per kilometer or something. How do you calculate the amount for an employee living close by versus an employee who lives farther away?
This is what I said. Maybe it didn't come up. So in the first moment, we decided not to go for mobility budget because it's from the taxation point of view, very complicated topic in Germany. So depending on the transport provider, there's different amount of taxes need to be paid. So for the first period of time, we decided not to go for mobility budget at all. So it's actually only access and different modes and seamless mobility, which we in the first moment will offer our employees. In the second step, we will think about question you raised, how we can subsidize, but not in the first 6 months.
And how are you going then to stimulate the colleagues to take the safe, green, sustainable mode of transport?
Good question, and not the easy one. Mm-hmm. So we don't use any limitation by now. We think of it, what we are going to do with our parking spaces, for example. So in headquarters, we have for 2,000 vehicles parking space. Before we think how we can use it differently, we need to provide alternative. And we decided first to go to provide brighter offering and then to think about limitation. So it might be experiment, you're right, I know what you're talking about. It might be experiment, we will see. But what we're also doing, and I think it's important not to undervalue it, awareness campaign. So we have also role models, we have Green Pioneers community, we have mobility experts community. So people, and those are not a small one, who's doing awareness work. We also prepared that two more board members will go at the role models, and I hope it will help us. If not, we need to think about some subsidies, mobility budget, and so on. But it's not that DT doesn't want to invest money in this. It's just because of some complication in the regulation in this moment.
Yeah. Yeah, and people want fun, sustainable, and easy seamlessness. Eh? So that will help stimulating.
What also important for us, we will allow to use, not allowed, we will also give this solution not only employees, but family and friends. So it's important that you use this solution also in spare time. And can you use it with your family? And I think it's also a big awareness shift.
Okay, and Olga, question from the audience. How do you decide, so what is your decision process on which kind of mobility solutions can or cannot be included in the platform?
We build platform at the open one. So we are open for everybody. So there is no exclusion decisions. In the first moment, we decided for transport provider who's available in this area. So it was the easy one, available in the Cologne Ball area and also covering Germany. So we opened for each provider. We started with the exclusive couple of, because they are present in Cologne and Bonn area, but we are open for also other transport providers.
Yeah. And another question, it's coming from Louis Couchet. Thank you for that. So Luikus, we're questioning, how did you motivate the various players to join this platform, and especially in relation to payment and securing payment?
We hadn't to motivate, frankly speaking. So we had bigger discussion with public transport, because public transport is not that open in Germany. And as Deutsche Telekom, I think we joined trust. We hadn't had this big discussion with public transport provider. We have already three on the platform. I cannot tell the name until it's not efficient. And we hadn't had discussion on it, or we hadn't had a big argument. The point is also that we providing with this solution pretty big customer base. So we're going in the corporate mobility with 100,000 employees, and we calculating actually with 500,000 at the end because of family and friends. So I think it's a good argument speaking about this good customer base who will using your service. And we hadn't by now big discussion on this. I think what is discussion, it's a customer.
Mm-hmm.
I tell you why, because I give you an example. If the scooter company going deep integration and platform, and some people booking this because of scooter company, the customer will be shared in the platform platform economy, the fact. Customer will be shared, and this is bigger discussion.
Yeah. Okay, thank you for that. And it's a pilot starting soon, amazing large amount. How are you going to measure the satisfaction of the people, and what will be your improvement process?
So there are some classical KPIs like downloads, active user, and so on. We also include in app feedback, so there's feedback possible. But the easiest way, active users. So we can see how many people using this. They can give us feedback. And since I think it's an advantage, since our employees, I do believe we will have good exchange on this, whether app is, whether people are satisfied with the app or not. And normally our employees are very active on this. We also, so some people might ask, why you invest in money? There's no mobility budget yet. So how you want to increase usage? So we have some situation in Cologne-Bol area sitting, so close to us is also Deutsche Post and Postbank. So it's about 25,000 people who commuting every day here. And we have great situation that Bonn Cologne very much supporting corporates to consolidate commuting. So we do believe that it will help not only DT, but we have also great connection to Deutsche Post. So this might help us to get more user on the platform. And it means we're not only open for other transport providers, we're also open for other users of the platform.
Okay, great. Thank you so much. Yeah, I think with that, we come to the end of this session. So thank you so much, Olga. Please stay with us until the panel, and then we have the opportunity to ask a bit more. So that was really great.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much.